Chelsea field their most powerful side, one that promises to be the best in the club's history. And back in that side, after injury, is that determined young striker, Ian Hutchinson. He's missed the last three games, but now his physical strength will be an asset. Watford, meanwhile, know how tough it's going to be. They are without skipper Keith Eddie, but they have the skill and spirit that's already beaten Stoke and Liverpool. And, of course, they have Barry Endine, the man who scored the winner against Liverpool, a lively player who will need watching. Watford are dangerous underdogs, and Chelsea will not underestimate Endine and company. There's a wonderful atmosphere and tension about the place with a crowd of 55,000. Now, for everybody, Wembley is 90 minutes away.
And so it's Watford, in their shirts of gold, who get this semi-final away. Back to Peter Bonetti. Chelsea in their customary all-blue strip. Wally getting in and robbed by Osgood. And Scullion getting in before Harris. Garbutt. And now Love. Endine with Scullion outside him. Whatever happens today, this surely is the greatest day in the history of Eddie McCready, here he is, the history of Watford Football Club, the first time they've ever got to a semi-final. For so many years, Watford have struggled in the third division, now they're struggling in the second, and not many people give them very much hope in this semi-final against Chelsea, third from the top of the first division. And really, Watford's defence was very slow indeed to get that one away. It's Hudson now for Chelsea. Houseman and Hudson, and this time it's Wellborn taking it from the back and a corner to Chelsea. Watford in defence looking very shaky, very unsure of themselves. Chelsea, of course, rampaging through the last part of this season. They've lost only three of their last 30 games. Hudson and Dempsey right up, and it's there by Webb. David Webb. Precisely 2.5 minutes gone. David Webb, who scored the first goal in the last round against Queen's Park Rangers, almost as quickly. But they are the Chelsea supporters, and they are delighted. And there is the scoreline. Well, that really makes it tougher still for Watford. Ray Lug, who was such a hero against Liverpool, my goodness, they're going to look to him now. Duncan Wellborn, the skipper. Remember, they're without their normal skipper, Keith Eddie. Here's Wellborn again. Really losing out on that one. And here's Mullins for Chelsea. Garbutt, Scullion, and Dempsey for Chelsea.
Walker.
Well, I know one or two question marks against this goalkeeper, but he's done everything for Watford this afternoon. Certainly that was the best break for Chelsea for quite a while. Hutchinson, Hollins, and Lug is there first. And a free kick given to Watford. Owen to Wally. And McCready. Mike Packer. No, it's gone through instead to Lowe. Ending's gone bursting, or rather Garvin. Here he has gone bursting on a tremendous 30-yard run. Finding Scullion. The little dipper towards the near post. Ending to flick it on and Bonetti to gather. Beaten by the bounce, although in all honesty the pitch hasn't played nearly as badly as a lot of people feared. David Webb, Hutchinson, and Williams. Just under a minute to go to half time, plus a bit of injury time. Hutchinson to try another long throw. Dempsey trying to get under it and flick it on. Wally is there, and then Wellborn. Harris, Housman, a little too delicate, and Wellborn can get in. Sexton was saying before this game, the thing that had worried him about Watford was their great togetherness, the fact that they played together as a team for so long. And really it's been a wonderful team effort by Watford in this first half. And nobody can doubt that they more than deserve to be level. Endine and Hudson having a tussle, and the free kick given Chelsea's way. Talk about, there goes in fact the whistle for half time. David Webb, who put Chelsea ahead so early in the game. And it was Terry Garbett, there he goes, who scored that surprise equaliser for Watford, going in with manager Ken Furphy to make the half time score here at White Hart Lane. Chelsea 1, Watford 1. More soccer for you in just a couple of minutes. So Chelsea know just how much they've got to raise their game now to fight their way through to Wembley. 1-1 at half-time, and Watford well deserving to be right in this game. So Chelsea then getting us away for the second half. Owen, having a nice little 1-2 there with Garbett. Quite apart from scoring the goal for Watford, Garbett really has played such an active part right along that Watford front line. Packer putting it straight into touch, not very happy with himself. Cook, whom we've seen very little so far, with the throw for Chelsea. Cook again. Keeping that in. Harris. Hutchinson to try to get Housman away, and Wellborn is there. Still well won. Oh, putting it straight to Osgood. Lolly, Packer. And now Lug. And now Scullion. Trying to switch it there for Owen. Garbett. Good play by Watford. Someone backing up. Oh, but that's straight for Cook. Oh, Williams trying to take him from the back, but Cook is away. He's got Osgood in the middle. And Hutchinson as well. Oh! Almost in slow motion, it seemed, that save from Walker. Just managed to grab it and hold it at the second go. Garbett, Packer. Ending chasing and McCready putting Dempsey into trouble and then getting out of it, and Harris a little too slack with his clearance, but this time finding Cook. Still this slightly casual air about Chelsea, and Watford are showing so much more urgency about it. Charlie Cook. Chelsea's throw. Chelsea, McCready. Chelsea, Cook. Chelsea, Packer. Chelsea, playing it across field for Brian Owen. It's Harris to Webb. Hollins. And Osgood laying it off for Hutchinson. Hutchinson in turn laying it off for Hudson. There's Housman outside him, Osgood in the middle. And Osgood! Peter Osgood! 2-1 to Chelsea! Scored in every round, Peter Osgood. And now he's kept that record. And he puts Chelsea ahead. Poor Watford, there's the Chelsea crowd. At last, something for them to cheer. Poor Watford, who've done so much and deserve certainly to be level. And now behind again. Ken Watford, Ken Furphy of Watford on the right. And he must be very relieved, Dave Sexton on the left. Hudson. Beautifully measured ball there for Cook. Playing it wide of Williams. Oh, and Hutchinson doing the dummy, and Wally was behind him. Straight to Hudson. And that's Housman on the volley. Good work by Walker. He caught it well on the volley, though. And Dempsey, a backheader to Bonetti. Hudson. Taken from the back. And so a free kick given against Packer of Watford. Looks very much as though Watford are going to bring on a substitute. Brian Garvey, limbering up. Wally getting under it, but only as far as Hudson. Now Cook. Showing one dummy after another, but he's still got two men to get past. Offside. Desperately trying to attract the referee's attention to bring on Brian Garvey. I wonder if it's Duncan Wilborn who took that knock. Nobody seems to. In fact, it's Owen who looks. It's Owen who's going off, the number 11, Brian Owen, going off for Watford. So Garvey comes on. Dempsey, nodding it sideways there for Webb. Oh, good ball by Webb to Housman. Still he goes, and he's got a pretty tough left foot, is Housman. Still he goes on, and a goal by Housman! 3-1! And that really must be the killer. And it seemed that Peter Housman aimed to shoot three or four times and changed his mind. And still the chance was there. And finally he took it. So Peter Housman makes it 3-1 to Chelsea with just over a quarter of an hour to go. Osgood. Garbett. Wellborn. Oh, and Logue was having a right go at Osgood there, and he's surely got to stop that and have a word with him, and indeed he is. So it's a free kick to Chelsea. John Hollins to take it. Hutchinson trying to get underneath it, being held down by Wellborn. Cook. And Garvey right back to Garbett. Cook. Again, Brian Garvey. Dempsey. Cooley to Hudson. Harris. Hutchinson. Webb. Hudson following up. Cook. Oh, with his left foot. Well covered by Walker. Hudson, Cook, Hudson again, oh, through his legs, and now to Osgood, Hutchinson, still Hutchinson, there it goes, number four, by Hutchinson. So Watford, like Queen's Park Rangers and Crystal Palace before them, look like being demolished by this Chelsea side. So often Chelsea seem to save some of their best and most efficient work to the last third of the game. And with those three rather rapid goals, they really must have put this one beyond any doubt now. free kick to Watford. It's Wilborn to take the kick. Darbit and Webb away. Wilborn again. Wilborn. And Garbett. Williams. Webb. Osgood, please, still sticking faithfully to him. Lug. Oh, beaten by Housman. Garbett. Wally. And now McCready. Lug. To Wellborn. Watford still bravely coming forward, but Harris there to stop him this time. And McCready. And Hollins. Oh, the referee getting in the way, and so it's Endy to take it up for Watford. Wally to try one. And Benetti so assured. Charlie Cook. That one caught on the wind a bit. Hutchinson, Housman. Hutchinson. Oh, a nice little 1-2 there for Housman. There it is! Number 5. Peter Housman second. Chelsea's fifth. Chelsea 5, Watford 1. And Wembley is waiting for them. That was his second goal. Beautiful move there with Hutchinson. Lug. But now it's Chelsea all the way. Packer to Garbett. Harris, under a minute to go. Hutchinson with a throw that almost sets Housman away. Well, he scored 2 goals, so he should be fairly happy. Terry Garbett. Wellborn. Hutchinson. Osgood. Hutchinson. Played wide for Housman, Hollins and Cook to converge on it. Hollins. Hutchinson after it. Osgood! There it is for the 6! No, disallowed. Disallowed. Brilliantly conceived goal, but disallowed, presumably for offside. So 5-1 it stays. And there goes the final whistle. Chelsea are through to Wembley. They got there in 1967 and were beaten by Tottenham. Now they're there again by the handsome margin of 5-1. Watford for so long bravely a force in this game. In the end, demolished by the superior understanding and skills of Chelsea. Number 5, Walter Lees. What a superb game he had against Osgood. But in the end, it's Chelsea's day.